Hi, I'm Penny and this is Fraser and this is our Level 3 electricity video.
In the standard there are four key topics. There's AC circuits, DC circuits, capacitors and inductors.
Just like any other physics standard, we place a strong emphasis on your formulas and how we can use them to answer both calculation and conceptual questions. We're going to talk you through a couple of classic questions electricity will throw at you. A classic question that you'll get asked is explaining either the voltage or current over time graph for either capacitors or inductors. For example, if we were to turn on current for a capacitor, what would happen to its voltage? To answer this question, I think it's important to define voltage as potential difference rather than voltage. Therefore, it's easier for you to understand what is actually happening, because it's what potential difference is measured across what is the difference in charge across the two plates of the capacitor. So if we turn on a current, all of the electrons are going to flow towards one of the plates of the capacitor, and it's going to build up a relatively negative charge to the other plate, therefore increasing the potential difference, which is your voltage. So your voltage over time graph is going to be an increasing graph. For inductors, I think it's important for you to remember your Lenz's law, that the induced EMF is going to oppose the change in current.
Another question that comes up all the time is the idea of resonance in AC circuits. This can be quite a tricky one to explain, but since the answer is pretty much the same every single time, it's important to have an explanation down. What the important thing to realize is that your capacitor reactance and that your inductor reactances are equal and opposite at resonance, and so they're canceling each other out. This means that your system's impedance is just defined by your resistor's resistance, which also means that it's at a minimum. Because you have a minimum resistance, your current is going to be super, super high if you have a constant voltage. That means that, you know, you're going to get the brightest light or the loudest sound or something like that coming out of your circuit at resonance. Definitely look at some past exemplars to see how they structure the answer and kind of aim to replicate that in your explanations. This has been Study Time strategy video for Level 3 electricity. Remember, it's going to come down to one of AC circuits, DC circuits, capacitors and inductors. Almost always in your answers, you're going to be using a formula, so make sure that you're really, really familiar with the formula sheet and what all those formulas do.
This standard is probably the most conceptually difficult of the three standards in Level 3 Physics, so we would strongly recommend that you check out Study Time's Level 3 Physics walkthrough guide for electricity to understand these concepts in detail. But your formula sheet is also there to assist you with that. Good luck with your exam, and thanks for watching.